ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وزعيمنا وحبيبنا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم آمين. We are still continuing to address the issue of good manners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the form of respecting and responding to the system of rights and duties that Allah has mandated on us as humans and as Muslims in particular. One of those rights is the right that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made compulsory, which is the right to equal justice. The right to equal justice for every human being, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you to give back the trusts that you have been entrusted with to the owners of those trusts, and to establish justice. If you judge between people, that your ultimate and only purpose is to seek what is just and implemented. Because the entire world is created on two principles, balance and justice. With balance, there is justice, and with justice, there is balance. And when balance is lost, everything else becomes unstable. Nothing becomes stable. And that's why you might have seen in the past few days when temperatures fluctuate between 40 to minus 6 or anywhere in between, it's too hard. It's too hard to live in a fluctuating weather. And that's only one element. What if the earth is unstable? What if the sun is unstable? What if the galaxy in which we live is unstable? How could we have life? So life as a whole has been set on both balance and justice. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, كُنُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ. Be you standing on the foundation of what is just, what is stable, what is straight and upright. This is the stand of the Muslim. شهداء لله, witnesses unto Allah. ولو على أنفسكم, even if it is against yourself. والوالدين أو الوالدين, or your parents. والأقربين, or your kin. So you have to be careful when it comes to the issue of justice. Ask yourself this question: who's watching you? Whom are you working for? Because in many cases, unfortunately, we tilt, and Allah says, do not tilt. فلا تتبعوا الهوى أن تعدلوا. Don't you follow your whims, lest you would tilt justice, and you will tilt away facts, analysis, and conclusion from what is just and what's fair. Every day in our life, we are presented with issues that require our justice, demand our justice. To be just, even if it is against ourselves, means that you establish justice against yourself. When you do something wrong, to anyone, it is not fair to try to escape responsibility. It is not right to blame somebody else, saying, because you did this, I did this, that's blaming. There is no reason to be unjust, except if you are following your whims, and we are prohibited from living according to our desires, even living according to our feeling. Some people judge everything by feeling. I felt this is the right thing to do. Feeling is not knowledge. Feeling is not ilm. Feeling is not a foundation for judgment. And feeling does not deliver you even your own best interest. Allah prohibited us from following our feelings and senses. Maybe you feel afraid of something, or you feel that you hate something, but it is good for you. Maybe you like something so much, but it is bad for you. So if we live by our feeling, we live away from justice. And who deserves our justice more than Allah? To be just with Allah, to respect His rules, and to stop at the limits that He sets, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to monitor what you say and what you do, recognizing that you are living under His care. قُلْ مَنْ يَكْلَأُكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ مِنَ الرَّحْمَانِ. Who takes care of you, the whole of you, by day and by night? Think about it. It's a question, rhetorical question, but it begs the right answer. Who protects you by day and by night? If it is Allah, then observe Him. اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. So when it comes to judging, one has to live by only one criteria, that is to fear Allah, to fear the wrath of Allah, to fear that you may tilt a little bit away from justice, and then you would call the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Then after Allah comes our way of dealing with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some of us think that because the Prophet is already dead, then we have actually no relationship with him. But we do. We do. And it is listed in the Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Don't you advance your own argument ahead of what Allah offers you. Don't advance your own reasoning ahead of the reasoning Allah gives you. Don't advance your logic or your conclusion or use it to argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or with His Messenger. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to us through the Quran that was given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And التقديم بين يدي الله, to advance your own logic and reasoning ahead of Allah, means that before you read the Quran, you are advancing using your own logic, and as such, you don't care what Allah says. That is putting yourself and your logic ahead of what Allah gives you of facts and interest and means and tools to judge, and judge based on what is just in Allah's eyes, because that is what is important. It is not important what your views are. What is important is what is Allah's view of the matter. This is what matters. So لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. Somebody is telling you the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says so and so. You say, but I say so and so. That is تقديم بين يدي الله ورسوله. That is pushing your argument ahead of what Allah and His Messenger guides you to do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not separate the fact that the Prophet is dead sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that then Muslims have no relationship with him. You do have a relationship with him. Allah ordered us and says, أطيع الله, obey Allah, which is to follow the Quran, But then part of obeying Allah is also to obey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ Clear, separate and subsequent instruction. That you cannot say, I am a Muslim, I listen to the Quran, but I don't listen to the Hadith, I don't listen to the Prophet. That becomes, يُرِيدُونَ أَن يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ People who disbelieve in Allah, they want to separate between Allah and His Messenger. They say, we believe in some, and we don't believe in others. And unfortunately, some Muslims want to pick and choose from the Hadith what is convenient. Or what is easy, or what is they think beneficial to them, to their interest or perceived interest. But Allah say, "Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul," independent. So when Allah orders, we listen. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam orders, we listen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts forth a warning: فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. Let them be careful, those who do not want to obey the Prophet, they want to deviate from the commands of the Prophet, lest they would be put through tumultuous times and difficulties, or else they will be afflicted with severe torment. So listening to the Prophet, listening to the Hadith, listening to the Quran, and following through what Allah commands us is definitely for our best interest. Then when it comes to justice, unfortunately, we lose it most with the closest people in our lives. Parents, children, spouses, relatives, we lose justice because in those relationships, unfortunately, we take each other for granted. When you live with someone for long, you get used to them and you take their presence and their relationship for granted. But Islam requires that we continue to seek to make sure that my relationship with you is as satisfying to you as it is to me. Because no relationship can be sustained by force. Not even a parent with a child, or a husband with a wife, or a neighbor with a neighbor. All of those relationships are voluntary. So you have to keep feeding it. You have to keep nurturing those relationships. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا Say that which is good. And when people conflict with you, the Quran says, ادفع بالتي هي أحسن Push back in a way that is better than their ways or the previous ways you used before. So our relationships require necessarily that we at least maintain the minimum. And the minimum is justice. إن الله يأمر بالعدل What else? والإحسان العدل, justice, is to give everybody their due rights. Whatever you owe anyone, you are a parent, your children have rights, you have to deliver good on those rights. From education, to health care, to guidance, to everything you can. To teach them everything you have learned. Because they are going to be parents for their own children. So you have to equip them, you have to train them. You have to take care of them. And the most you need to pay attention to is their heart and their mind. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, أدبوا أولادكم Raise your children على حب الله To love Allah وعلى حب نبيكم And to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam وعلى تلاوة القرآن And raise them on the recitation of the Quran, which means teach them the Quran. If we don't teach our kids the Quran, what are we teaching them? What do they learn? They learn anything else but the most important book in their life. So as a matter of justice, the basic foundation is to give people their due rights. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells children to be respectful, to be kind, to be decent, to be courteous with their parents, and to show them the utmost humility and the utmost respect. So much so that Allah says, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Don't you utter the slightest word of disrespect. Don't you show any sign of resentment. Otherwise, you are in violation of the Quran. So we should not take those relationships for granted. But even above and beyond justice, which is to give everybody their due, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that relationships are better nurtured by ihsan, not just by justice. Not by doing your minimum. And unfortunately, even the minimum, many of us are not doing it. Many of us are not doing their basic duty to raise their children as Muslims, to treat their spouses the way they ought to be treated according to Allah, according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Well, basically, we are not even putting effort to learn what are those rights so that we observe them. We don't have even in our head what are those rights. We assume things, but on what basis? We don't spend time to learn our deen, and that means what we are living by is only inherited ideas. Whether they are consistent with Islam or just part of our culture, we are using them because we heard them. We heard somebody say, this is what you need to do. But Allah says, al-ihsan, goodness and righteous relationships, is what maintains a prolonged relationship. And that has to be mutual. So Allah commands parents to take care of children, and Allah commands children to be respectful and to obey and to listen to their parents. All relationships are reciprocal. You have to feed and you have to receive. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to always keep this balance in all of our relationships, so that our relationships are leading us to both stability and comfort. In any relationship, there are three levels that you have to satisfy so that this relationship is both helpful, beneficial, and leads to your happiness and stability. The first level is acceptance, to accept each other, both as humans with frailties and shortcomings, and also as a partner in this relationship. So if a student doesn't accept the teacher, or the teacher doesn't accept the student, the educational process as a whole will crumble. If a parent doesn't accept and embrace the child, and the child embraces back their parents, then there is no relationship. If a husband and wife are resentful towards each other, then there is no mercy, there is no mawadda, there is no love, and as such, there is no ihsan in the relationship. So Allah wants us to show the ultimate acceptance, that you are my son, I love you no matter what, but I love you more if you are obedient to Allah. I love you more if you study your deen. I love you more if you have discipline and commitment to your faith. I will give you more, if I have any to give you, if you do more when it comes to your relationship with Allah, your relationship with your future, your relationship with your mother, with your neighbor, with your father. Those added benefits only can come when you show that you take your responsibilities seriously. But if you play around, if you neglect your duties, how do you ask for more? How do you ask for more? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He can give anyone anything and everything, and nothing decreases of His dominion, but He says, اذكروني اذكركم, to set the relationship on a reciprocity foundation. The foundation of every relationship is mutual reciprocity, which means that you do good and the other person will do in return as good or even better. So Allah commands us to do what? Justice and ihsan. Ihsan, which you can translate literally into excellence, is to do to others better than they do to you, and to do to them more than what justice requires. So if you have a neighbor and the neighbor is inappropriate, or he is hurting you by what he says or something, look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a model. He had a neighbor of this kind, and when that neighbor stopped bothering him, the Prophet went all the way to check on him and found that he was sick. So he went and visited him. This is the manner. This is idfa billati hiya ahsan. Push back in manners and ways that are better. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, لا يكن أحدكم إمعة. Let not any one of you be an idiot reactionary person. يقول إن أحسن الناس أحسنت. If people are good to me, I'm going to be good to them. وإن أساءوا أسأت. And if they do bad, I will do bad. ولكن وطدوا أنفسكم. Hold yourself to the discipline. إن أحسن الناس أن تحسنوا. If people are good to you, you do better to them. And if they are inappropriate or bad or attacking or slanderous, then تجنبوا الإساءة. وإن أساءوا أن تتجنبوا الإساءة. Avoid doing to them what they are doing to you. If you don't like what they are doing, don't do it back. Because if you do it back, the dynamic will be escalation. You say one word, he says two words, you say three words, it keeps escalating, it turns into a fight. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, don't be an idiot follower to the manners of other people. Be a follower of the manners of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If people are good, you do better. If people are bad to you, you still hold on to your manners, to your principles, and do good, if not better. So we have to live a life where our relationship with Allah is guided only by what Allah expects of us. Allah expects justice, He expects goodness, He expects righteousness, and He defines all of this to us in the Quran. So we have those principles. وَأَقِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ. In business, don't shortchange somebody for what you owe them, and do not try to take from them what is not yours. Even the Prophet ﷺ went as far as saying, إِنَّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ عِنْدِي أَوْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ إِلَيَّ. You come with your disputes to seek my judgment. وَإِنِّي لَأَحْكُمُ لِأَحَدِكُمْ. And I judge for one of you just because he is more articulate. He speaks well. So he says, if it is the case that you know that I judged for you just because you are more convincing, don't take what I give you. Even if the Prophet judges for you, the Prophet in person, don't take it. If you know that it is not yours, you got it by argumentation, by logic, by hook or crook, or by gimmicks, or by any other means, don't take it, even if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in person is giving it to you. Some of us go to someone to judge between them, and they only hope that he gives them the maximum, not the right. The only wish or hope they have is that he gives me more than what I deserve, because I want to defeat the other side. I'm not interested in justice. I'm not interested in what is right for me. And if we always think based on what is right and what is just, we will do justice even if it is against ourselves. or our interests or our parents or our children, because we love Allah more than we love what this judge or that judge may give us. So we Muslims should only be seeking what is ours and never take what is not, even if the courts give it to us or anybody gives it to us. I get this question frequently. Somebody says, I ran into an accident and the court gave me that much, and I know that my car is not worth that much. Should I take it? Because he's not going to take it from the court, he's going to take it from the other side. Should I take it or should I not? And I tell them, listen to the Prophet. He says, if it is not yours, don't take it. Even if 10 courts gave it to you, don't take it. Wives who go and sue their husbands for money by way of divorce or custody or anything, and the courts sometimes they judge because of certain considerations and they give the wife or the husband for that matter something more than what they know is their fair right. Again, take not what is not yours. Don't say, the court gave it to me, that is what I have. Because Allah will ask you, what did you take? Was it worth it? The court tells you, you pay to your child $150 a month or $200 a month, and you know you could do better. Let me tell you this. Many people hide their income from the court so that they pay their children less. That shouldn't be the Muslim's approach. That is not seeking justice or even thinking about justice. This is thinking selfish, not justice. So brothers and sisters, it is not good manners with Allah that we trample over the principles of justice so long as we know what the justice in the matter is. It doesn't work this way. Otherwise, the person you wrong the most is you. But some of us unfortunately think that the more I take, the smarter I am. Or if I want to prove that I'm smarter than the other side, I want to get more. And I always tell people, give back what is not yours. Don't take it. Don't take it. There are cases when people actually left their job to go to the court and claim they are unemployed because they don't want to pay, whether it is spousal support or children support. Some, of course, believe wrongly that spousal support is not in Islam. It is in Islam, especially when there are children. Especially when the wife has worked for you for years to serve you and to make you comfortable. Spousal support is part of Islam. The Quran calls it nafaqah. It is expenditure, or it is spending on your wife after divorce until she is able to stand on her feet. But some people think, no, I will pay my children, I will never pay her a penny. Man, after 10, 15 years of service, yes, because she asked for divorce. Yeah, but you have no right to punish your wife unjustly just because she is unable to live with you. She is unable to deliver on her commitment as a wife to you for whatever reason. Unless she commits clear, proven, evident adultery, she has the right to her nafaqat al-idda. And there is another nafaqa called nafaqat al-mut'a. وَمَتِّعُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Give them something to live on for some period according to the norm. What does the norm say? The norm in some countries is a wife who is divorced, she goes back to her family. But here, there is no much extended families for many people. So where does she go? Shelter with her children? Where does she go? Homeless? So we have to always think what is just, what is fair in the eyes of Allah, not according to my desires. Not according to my desires. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us love and respect His rules and live by those rules in a just and balanced life. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. الله سبحانه وتعالى also goes as far as saying be just even with your enemies. With your enemies. We spoke about relatives and families, but even with your enemies. Allah says وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Don't you be driven by your animosity or conflict with somebody that you do not practice justice and you tilt away from justice. Allah says be just, اِعْدِلُوا with your enemies. With your enemies. In the beginning of the same surah, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ أَنْ صَدُّوكُمْ عَنِ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ أَنْ تَعْتَدُوا. Don't you be driven by your animosity or conflict with the people who prevented you from going to the Masjid Haram in Mecca, that you commit injustice. What an amazing religion. What is this? Does the Quran want us to be angels? No, the Quran wants us to be decent humans. To be more interested in peace and justice than our enemies. To be more interested in what is good and what is right and what is fair than your enemy. But that doesn't mean that you do not defend yourself. To stop aggression, defend yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَكُمْ. Be ready and be prepared to defend your country, to defend your nation, to defend your faith, to defend your honor, your dignity, your community, but don't commit aggression and don't commit injustice. Do you know when the Quran condemned shirk, it described it as what? Grave injustice. إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. We know that shirk is the worst thing anybody could commit. Here the Quran is saying, when condemned, shirk is the worst form of injustice. So at the root of it is injustice. Because how come that Allah creates you and you worship an idol? How come Allah creates you and what you have and you worship what you get and don't worship He who gives? How? That is unjust. That is unfair. So shirk is condemned as the worst form of injustice. So to be decent, to have good manners with Allah, we have to treat Allah the way He ought to be treated. To respect His words. To be disciplined in living by His guidance. To give Him our utmost commitment. And to treat all of His creation justly. those who are with you and those who are against you. Justice keeps the balance, it keeps the boundaries, and it keeps peace. And without justice, there will never be peace between people. Why people go into wars? Because they feel the grave injustices that others are committing against them. Why do people revolt against tyranny? Because tyranny is one of the worst forms of human injustice against each other. Why do people revolt against business owners when they are not paying the workers their dues or not paying it on time? So we have to be careful that the only way to keep peace in the family, to keep peace in the society, to keep peace in the community, to keep balance in our life, is to, at a minimum, be just, but better yet, to be good, to live a godly life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our hearts to live a godly life. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. وإذا أردت بقومنا فتنة فنجنا منها يا مولانا، غير خزايا ولا مفتونين ولا مبدلين ولا مغيرين. اللهم لا تدع لنا في يومنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا كربا إلا نفسته، ولا ضالا إلا هديته، ولا سائلا إلا أعطيته، ولا مستغيثا إلا أغثته، ولا مستنصرا إلا نصرته، ولا ظالما إلا قسمته، ولا جبارا إلا كسرته. اللهم عليك بالجبارين، وعليك بالظالمين، وعليك بالطغاة المتكبرين. اللهم هيئ لأمتنا أمر رشد يعز فيه أهل طاعتك، ويخذل فيه أهل معصيتك، ويؤمر فيه بالمعروف وينهى فيه عن المنكر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فستذكرون ما أقول لكم، وأفوض أمري إلى الله. إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.